Very good morning, children. I hope all of you are fine at home. So in today's class, we are going to start reflection of light at curved surfaces. In the previous classes, you might have studied about reflection of light at plane surfaces, and this is about curved surfaces. And there are very important terminology regarding this chapter. So we will try to cover certain keywords from this lesson in today's video class. See, children. I have written certain important keywords on the board. Reflection of light at curved surfaces. Okay, before going to learn about curved surfaces and how the light will be reflected, okay, we will try to learn some important terminology. See the first one, that is spherical mirrors. What are spherical mirrors? The mirrors which have curved surfaces are known as spherical mirrors. Generally, we know about plane mirrors. Plane mirrors have plane surface. Whereas spherical mirrors are the mirrors which have the curved surface. So due to that curved surface, they are known as spherical mirrors. In this lesson, we are going to learn about two types of spherical mirrors, that is concave mirrors and convex mirrors. Okay, children. So the mirrors which have curved surfaces are known as spherical mirrors. Then center of curvature. So it is the center of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. Suppose, let us imagine, or let us draw a curve which is shown with blue color here. I have drawn a curve. So this is a blue color. Blue color one is a curve. Let us extend this line. That means let us draw an imaginary circle. In order to complete the circle, in order to complete the curve, whatever curve I have drawn here, let us draw an imaginary circle completing the curve. When we draw completed curve, this becomes a sphere. This becomes a sphere. Okay. For this sphere, there will be the center of the sphere. It is known as the center of the sphere. This curve belongs to which sphere and what is the center of that sphere? This center of the sphere acts as a center of the curvature too. Okay, center of the curve. This center of the curvature is denoted by capital C. So, it is the center of the sphere of which this mirror belongs to. Okay, center of the curvature is always denoted by capital C. Girls, next, radius of curvature. It is the radius of the sphere of which the mirror is a part. Radius of the sphere. Radius means you all know. So, let us imagine in this sphere. Again, what will be the sphere? What will be the radius of the sphere? Here, it is from the point, from this point to this point. It is called as a radius of the sphere. And so, the radius of the sphere of which the mirror is a part, it is denoted by R. And for a simple understanding, in order to remember it easily, we can also say that radius of the curvature is nothing but it is the distance between the pole and center of the curvature. Okay, what is pole? Here, what is the pole? Pole is nothing but the midpoint of the curve. See, this is the curve. Midpoint of the curve is this one. That means it is the geometrical center of the curve. Okay, midpoint of the mirror is also called as geometrical center of the mirror. And it is denoted by the letter P. Okay, it is called pole and it is denoted by the letter P. This is, all of you know that this is the center of the curvature. C is the center of the curvature. P is the pole of the mirror. And the distance between pole and center of the curvature is known as radius of the curvature. And here I have shown you. Radius of the curvature is denoted by the letter capital R. Okay. R is equal to 2F. I have written here. Why? Because C. Here capital F is there and small f is there. We will see what are these letters indicate. Next, principal axis. The line passing through the pole and the center of curvature of the mirror is called its principal axis. Okay, the line passing through the pole of the mirror. As I have already said you that P represents the pole of the mirror. Okay, C represents the center of the curvature of the mirror. Then the line passing through the pole and center of the curvature of the mirror is called as the principal axis of the mirror. Okay, this is the horizontal line which is passing through pole and center of the curvature. Hence, and this is known as the principal axis of this curved mirror. Then pole, it is the, we have already said you that it's the midpoint of the spherical mirror or the geometrical center of the spherical mirror. Okay, this is called the geometrical center of the spherical mirror or midpoint of the spherical mirror is called as pole and it is represented with the letter P. Next, focus or focal point. It is the point on the principal axis, okay, try to understand, at which the rays parallel to the principal axis meet or converge. After reflection, for a concave mirror, R appears to come from for convex mirror, and it is denoted by the letter capital F. Focal point is the point on the principal axis. You can observe clearly in this picture, in this diagram. See, this one is the, this middle one is the, which I have indicated with red color mark, is the principal axis. Okay, this is the spherical mirror. This is the principal axis. This geometrical center will be in the center part, and it is pole will be present here, and this is the focal point. Why do we call it as the focal point, children? Let us try to understand here. When the light rays which are parallel to the principal axis are falling on the mirror, on the reflected surface of the mirror, then these reflected rays, after the passing through this mirror, these reflected light rays will be actually converging. They will meet at one point on the principal axis, and that point is said to be the focal point for that mirror. In case it is, if it is a concave mirror, in case if a concave mirror is taken, in that case the light rays which are parallel to the principal axis, when pass through the reflecting surface of the mirror, after passing through the mirror, the reflected rays will be coming and meeting at a certain point on the mirror, certain point on the principal axis. That point at which all the light rays, all the reflected light rays will meet or converge at point, that point is called as focal point. Okay, this is the principal axis and this is the focal point, or it is also known as principal focus or focal point. It is represented with capital F. Okay, if it is the concave mirror, then in case of convex mirror, what happens means, after reflection, the reflected rays appears to come from one point on the principal axis. Appears to come from, here we have to use the words, appears to come from, the reflected rays appears to come from a point on the principal axis after reflection. Then that point is known as focal point for a convex mirror. Okay, that one also will be learning in the future classes based upon the diagrams. If you draw the ray diagrams, you can clearly understand for convex mirror also. Okay, principal axis, that point on the principal axis, that is called as the focal point. Okay, and focal length, it is the distance between P and F. It's denoted by small f, and it's the distance between P and F. Okay, the principal, the focal point will be here. See, here this midpoint is the focal, midpoint is the pole of the mirror, and this is the focal point of the mirror. The distance from pole to focal point is called as focal length, and it is represented by small f. Okay, here also I have represented you. Here, this is pole, this is the focal point. In between these two, the distance between pole and focal point is called as length. Okay, focal length is represented with small f, and this is the center of the curvature. From pole to center of the curvature, whole distance is called as the radius of the curvature, and this horizontal line is called the principal axis. So these are the important terms, children. We have to understand the difference between all these terms, and here how to represent focal point and focal length, it is also very, very important. Focal point is represented with capital F, and focal length is represented with small f. And here, radius of the curvature is equal to 2 times to that of the focal length of the mirror. This is the focal length. Here to here is the focal length. And this focal point, this capital F focal point will be in the exactly in the center of the radius of the curvature. So, if we double this focal length, we will get the radius of the curvature. Hence, I have written here R is equal to 2F. R is the radius of the curvature. Small f is the focal point, focal length. So, when you double the focal length, you will get the radius of the curvature. R is equal to 2F. Or if you want to get the focal length, F, small f is equal to R by 2. Like that also, we can write. Small f is equal to R by 2. If you know the radius of the curvature, radius of the curvature, and if you want to know the focal length, then F is equal to R by 2. Okay, R is equal to 2F. These are some important words. So, try to note down some main points from this, and we will meet in the next class, children. Thank you.